Sure.
Guitars are lined up and everything.
Where all the guitars are lined up?
Yeah, there's five, six of them. So.
What's this?
Sorry?
What's this?
Which one?
So we are this evening. We are with Gaurav Patte, whom I know as a student and
yes.
many other things. But he's also a budding musician, a good musician, extremely adept collector of musical instruments.
Musical instruments, yes. As you can see, some of them over here, sir.
Some of them, many of them.
Many of them, yes.
Total number now?
About 40.
Wow.
About 40 of
40.
Them. Yes, 40 of them.
When did it start and what triggered it?
It started initially with a bass guitar. Because
yeah.
I'm an avid music lover. And what happened is, as soon as I started working as I'm a teacher,
yeah, yeah.
I got some money. Now
yeah.
I wanted to spend that money somewhere. And I felt the
somewhere
best
productive.
Thing, yeah, somewhere productive. The best thing was to do is, because I don't usually dabble in other things, I like collecting instruments and learning them by myself.
This is your only vice, like main vice?
Yes, this is my main vice. Main vice. Not the only one, but main one.
Okay.
Yes, so I like to collect instruments and learn them by myself whenever I have the free time
yeah.
to do so.
Yeah.
Most people, you see, this is just a few of them that you can see
yeah.
lined up here. Bunch of flutes, this matki, the djembe. So, should I start?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My
please,
favorite
please,
one.
Please.
My favorite one would be this one, the tung drum. Okay, this is the one that I usually like to start with, and this is about 25,000 for this one.
Wow.
It's a custom order from Ukraine, so you won't find it here in India. At
yeah.
all. Like
yeah.
the ones you find here are rip-offs and they're just simply costly and they don't make the proper sound. So it's an empty cylinder as you can see here.
Yeah.
Yes. So it makes a sound by resonance.
Made of?
Steel.
Steel.
Steel handpan, tongue drum kind of thing.
What?
Okay.
There must be a lot of science in making it, no? Nonetheless.
Actually there is. If you go to find out, the father of this instrument is called a handpan, which was built by a physician and a music instrument maker from Switzerland. Felix Rauner and Sabina Scherer, their name is. So they spent about 7 years making the father of this instrument.
Yeah.
This was based out of that one. So this is cheaper. The handpan actually costs about 1 lakh, which I cannot afford for now.
You said it's your dream to buy one day.
It's my dream to buy it one day. I can't afford it for now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or I might buy it very soon. So it makes a sound. You see, these it's called a tongue drum because these are tongues cut out on it. So strike one.
Each one a different note.
Each one is a different note. So it's it's like that. So also when you strike a note, right?
Yeah.
If you mute everything else, it sounds different.
I see.
So it has a certain bloom to it. The sound blooms when you see everything vibrates.
I see.
It's like supporting the main note. So
amazing, amazing,
is,
amazing.
Whatever I'm playing is just my own stuff. I like to make original music. That's what I feel is the purpose. So this is...
There's some magic
fingers.
In your fingers. Not anyone can play it that way. How long did it take you to master that?
I don't think I have mastered it, but it's been a couple of years since
I
I'm playing this. You can also strike it and see how
And it gets better with time?
Absolutely.
No, I'm useless.
Absolutely. Absolutely gets better with time. Absolutely. So
I see. So first when you bought it, like it looked like a dud or...
First time I bought it, it sounded very nice as well because that time I didn't know much about music.
Okay.
But then after a while, you get stuck in that plateau kind of stuff where
yeah.
you're not really progressing. You say, okay, I'm playing the same things over and over again. But with collecting more instruments and learning about scales and music and how each thing connects, I think this thing is revealing more and more to me. The more time I spend
I
with it, the more better it gets. So I also, what I do is actually combine a couple of them.
I see.
So, that's my dog there. He loves this instrument, by the way. So, this is a djembe.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah, yeah.
This is
which part of Africa? Australia.
Foli tribe. That's the one that is well known. This is a ghungru from India.
Yeah.
So, what
yeah.
I do is this. I put it up on my... Put it up here. And this is mainly because, like, if I want to jam with somebody,
yeah.
they aren't available or they're too busy, so I'd rather jam with myself. So I make songs just by, you know, combining a few things, and here it is, goes like this. Thank you. like doing it. If nobody's there to jam with me, I'd rather jam with myself. You know, just make some music somehow or the other. So this really helps as, you know, just accompaniments.
The Gungru is from Rajasthan or?
Yes, all over India. All over India. A lot of South Indian dances also
I
use
see.
The Gungru. And it's quite nice. So that's one
and
day.
The cost of that Gungru?
Gungru, if you go to buy it in the store, it costs about 2K or 1K.
Yeah.
Depends on what quality you're buying. I bought it online for like 300.
I see.
Flipkart.
I see.
So there's a pair, so I just need one anyways. So the other one is there. In case this gets spoiled, I have the other one. So yeah, now moving on from that one, this is a very meditative instrument, as you can see. So it's this one. This is a Tibetan singing bowl. Now this is an original handmade one. So it goes. Then you can. That's a really cool trick with this actually. If you add water to it,
I see.
I will show you.
Yeah.
Now there's some water in this.
I see.
And it can actually sort of, I don't know how to say it, but it does in a certain way control water.
Control?
Movement of water.
I see.
Okay. So you see some shapes going on in that. So.
Oh gosh.
Yes.
My goodness.
Yeah, you can see that.
I see.
Yes. So this is the effect sound has on water, right? On water, and our bodies are what, 72% water? Our heart is 70% water.
Right.
So imagine what sound can do to you every day when you listen to it, right? So that's the Tibetan singing bowl used by monks in the monasteries for meditation. And it has only one note and you have to focus on that one thing. So it's oneness with everything, right? So there are other versions of it. This is a ceramic one.
That's made of?
That's made of brass.
Brass.
So, that one was about 5K. I bought it off a store. This is a Flipkart online version, ceramic one, 700 rupees only. It's got a different sound. Yeah. So you can keep it going like this. If you keep doing this, it'll go on for hours and hours and hours.
Yeah. A single note?
Yes, just this. Keep doing this, it'll go on.
My
just
goodness.
Keeps going on. Doesn't stop at all.
Infinity, yeah?
Infinity, absolutely. That's a trick, sir.
And all science generated over ages, no?
Yes, absolutely.
You probably in Hyderabad seen that fort or it's a fort there where you clap at the gate and you can hear it right
away. Yes. They have a lot of those kind of places.
Amazing,
all over
no?
India. Yeah, amazing stuff that is undiscovered by most people.
Yeah.
So this is a machine-made one.
I see.
Again from Nepal. This was a gift from Nepal. So. Keeps going if you keep doing this.
If anyone appreciates your work and wants to gift you some instrument, you're happy to collect.
Oh, yes, please. Yes. I will accept wholeheartedly. Few of them are gifts. Most of them are my own. So
it could become a museum someday, no?
It could, very well. That's the goal, sir. That's the goal. Someday I have my, you know, own big house and one room could be made only for musical instruments. My whole message or goal is to basically take music everywhere I go, so that people get inspired to play. Because there are a lot of friends who say, dude, you carry instruments everywhere because of you, I picked up a ukulele or I picked up a flute or this.
I see.
So that's what I like doing. That's what I want to
and
make.
And Goa is such
music.
A musical place, no? Both Eastern and Western and Indian and, you know,
exactly.
All
exactly.
Influences from all over.
Absolutely, absolutely. Mm. And it's always nice when you combine both of them.
Yeah,
the combination of Indian and Western.
Yeah, fusion, no, in
fusion,
that sense.
As always.
I mean, music has no language or no culture or no boundary in that sense. It's all in the mind.
Exactly, it's all in the mind, sir. Absolutely. So, then moving on to, these are a few shakers. This is from Pedro Fernandez.
I see.
So, you can use this with like.
He actually sells this?
Yeah, he actually sells.
People
this.
Use them?
People use them in music, yes.
Really?
Yes, they do. So, like if you're playing this also. You can just combine all of them. Now, this is one. This is also a shaker.
I see.
This is something that you can actually put on your hand. So if you're like,
oh gosh.
Yeah. So playing this one.
Two for the price of one.
Absolutely. This is a wonderful one. You can, many people make these at home actually with rice and maybe some small bond or coconut.
Yeah.
And you can just open it up. If you can pack it nicely, you can make these. Experimenting is.
I remember in those days they used to make from the tea boxes, no? They used to make those base kind of
single strings. Absolutely, absolutely.
For parties and all that.
Yes, correct.
In the 70s when musical instruments were really hard to come by.
Yes, absolutely. That's that thing. And also, I think the best thing is making your own musical instruments. I'm in the process of making some. I have a friend who has a garage there in Tivim. So we sit and we experiment on like old dead guitar bodies. And we make something new out of
them. We'll record your YouTube videos also now.
My videos are recorded everywhere, but there we
garage.
Yeah, in the garage, yes. We do record.
What do you call it? Garage?
It's just, that is the warehouse studio.
Warehouse studio.
The one you're talking about is the warehouse studio.
Where's
that's
that?
In Porvorim. That's in Porvorim. Okay. So that's basically my friend's basement where we sit and discuss about instruments.
Okay.
So.
There was a guy, a foreigner in Baga, who was actually teaching people to make guitars. I remember about 10 or 20 years back. Yeah. And the course cost about 8,000, 8K or something then. And he gave you a guitar at the end of it. Something like that.
Oh, wow.
I forget.
That's brilliant. Yeah. I don't know if he's still there.
No, this is like about 8, 12 years or maybe 20 years back. I photographed him, I remember.
Oh, yeah.
And there was a guy who, a bagpiper who had come to Kandoli and was playing the bagpipes and all these kind of things. Yeah.
That's nice. Bagpipes are hard to come by, at least in Goa. About 60,000 for a good one.
Oh, wow.
So I would like to buy one. I saw a second hand one in Pedro. It was 30K, but it was broken, so it would take more to fix it. So I never bought it. But think of bagpipes, the flutes are there.
Yeah.
They are similar to the bagpipes.
What are the varieties of your flutes from where?
This was my first one. This is from Pedro Fernandez. I just bought a flute because I was quite smitten by the concept of one, and I liked how it sounds. And actually, if you try to play a flute in the first time, right, you won't be able to even make a sound. It will just you keep doing that. And Pedro Fernandez Pierre, he told me that you keep doing that for 1 week, you get a sound out of it, and then you make music. I said you need patience with it, because if you don't have patience, it's not going to.
It's like whistling, no? You can't get started.
Exactly.
Getting started is
exactly.
Very tough.
So once you get a sound out of it, I'm not a flute player. I just make some random sounds which I can combine with my music. So
your vibrations are definitely attracting the birds for sure.
They're here, right? You can see.
Yeah, I can hear them.
There's four of them.
There are four of them.
There's four of them, right?
I see.
That's another beautiful part of music. When I usually the best time to practice a flute is early in the morning. So you wake up and instead of just looking at your phone, this, that, go outside, take a flute, and it's also a breathing exercise because your excessive breathing is going on there. And the birds usually come around in the morning. My dog comes and sits there, and it's a whole new place. You know, it's just amazing. Can't really describe that.
So the flutes are defined by geography, or they come from different cultural settings. So how are they different? It's all very Indian, no? Flutes.
These are bansuris, which are Indian and also a bit of Chinese influence.
The Dizi flute, Chinese influence.
So this is a bansuri. This was my first one that I bought.
Yeah.
This is a bansuri from 1994.
I see.
It's older than me.
I see.
So this was given to be my colleague. He used to be a flute player before. It's very difficult to play.
I see.
Yes, they do have an Indian origin, but also they are found in different cultures all throughout the world. Even in Native Americans, we have the Native American flute, which I think Rocky Lazarus plays.
I see.
He has a Native American flute, which is about, I think, 15,000 if you go to buy one. So I'm looking at buying one because I really like the sound of it.
And
it
Australian sounds, Aboriginals and all also.
Yes, absolutely. Even they have it. They have something called a didgeridoo.
Didgeridoo.
Yes, the big pipe. Yes, that one. So this is very difficult to play. Makes me breathless every time.
So, really?
Yes. It's as the bigger the instrument, the bigger the flute, more difficult it is to play. Because you need excessive amounts of
oxygen,
breathing and air to push the sounds out of it. And the best part of the flute is it's hollow. And that's kind of the point. It's that only when you're hollow you can learn something. Only when you're hollow from here, you can actually make music. It comes from somewhere else. That's what I learned.
And it's also very tough to do it, no?
It's also very tough to do. Very tough to do it. This flute, most people will take about a month to even make a sound out of it.
I see.
It took me about a week, but I managed to do so. Then, this is another flute. I got this from Bodhgeshwar Jatra.
I see. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Price?
This is, I think, 150.
I see.
Very, very simple.
Amazing, no? How people can produce.
And if I could play flute in a better way, I could be able to make really good music, but I can't. Especially the guys who sell these flutes, they make some really good tunes. Like, they're just walking around playing some beautiful melody and you wonder how are they doing that. And then you take the same flute in your hand.
It's not so easy. It's not easy at all.
Not easy at all. Not easy at all. But once you get a hang of it, then it's just sleight of hand.
Yeah.
This is an imported one. It's a Feedog tin whistle. So this is a Celtic tin whistle. They use it in Scotland and all these places. It sounds very different. It's a tin whistle, so.
Surprising, no? How different it sounds.
You see, very high pitched.
Yeah.
And this was used by most of these Celts and even the Vikings to a certain extent, the tin whistle was, because they were seafarers and they liked tin whistles for some reason.
I see.
So they made it out of, it's made out of, this one is made out of brass and this has this small blowing pipe over here and again makes beautiful sounds. You see the difference between all of them. This is, you know, the bansuri and makes this bass kind of notes.
Right, and size that. And bamboo.
Yeah, it's, exactly, bamboo and it's brass and wood.
The amount of work that goes into creating it, you can imagine, no? It looks like nothing.
Simple, right? It looks like nothing, but...
You get something wrong, it's not going to work.
Not going to work at all. Because, you see, this one is not in perfect tune. This is just made... I mean, of course, there is a lot of craftsmanship going into it.
Yeah.
This one, if you see, some holes are smaller, some holes are
bigger. See.
That's to control the note coming out of
gosh.
It. Because then it should not sound off, right? When you're it's an accompanying instrument. So if you're playing with somebody and you're playing out of key, they wouldn't want you to play with them, right? So this is a PVC flute. It's made out of PVC pipe.
Really?
Yeah.
From where? My goodness.
I bought it off Flipkart, 200 rupees only.
Oh gosh.
So it sounds very much different than all these other flutes because, well, it's made out of a PVC pipe. And there are many DIY videos on YouTube that you can, you know, check out to make these flutes. So. So this is the flute. Again, I'm not a flute player, but I like collecting them. I have 7 or 8 of them.
Wow.
Because I like collecting them. So this is
a lot of innovation in the field. Even in a place like India, there's a lot of innovation. Maybe marketing it and awareness may be a problem.
Very much. Very much. This is made by an Indian maker.
Where?
So, Radhe Flutes in Rajasthan.
Rajasthan.
So, he makes these out of PVC pipes, which I found to be very brilliant. And plus, they're dirt cheap. 200 rupees? That's about
Yeah, what's 200? You won't get 3 cups of tea for that.
Exactly. So, this is something that you can get for that amount of money.
And we need to create a map of India with all the musical instruments and where, which is the home to which instruments and what's popular where.
Oh,
no?
Yes. I think we should do that on GoaNet and...
Why not? I just need some artistic...
Yes. Some artistic
skills.
So this is a recorder flute. It's called a recorder flute, not because you can record it or something, but it's just called a recorder flute.
I see.
So again, this is made out of plastic as well, but this is a branded Yamaha one.
Wow.
This was a gift. I did not buy this. This is about 5,000 if you go to buy it in a shop. So I don't know again how to play it because it has one extra hole over here at the back. This is mostly used in Western music. That works. So yeah, this is a recorder flute. It's called a recorder flute. So these are the woodwind instruments that you see here. And most people know about flutes, but what they don't know is that these flutes have also inspired other instruments, or other instruments have inspired the flute, such as this one. This is called an ocarina. It's of Aztec origins, our favorite topic. So it's basically, this is made out of plastic. In the olden days, you could make it out of ceramic, wood, etc., etc. So again, it's hollow, and that's why it makes sound. So.
So what do your sister and parents make of your odd hobby of collecting musical instruments? They're used to it now.
Initially, they were like, you're spending money on these things. But then they heard me playing them and they were like, oh, this is cool.
Yeah.
What is this? Like, this looks very alien to them, right?
Yeah.
Like, how do you
It looks alien to everyone.
Yeah, exactly. And they asked me, how much did you pay for it? I always tell them half the price. I can't tell the full price.
I hope they watch this video. So they...
They surely will. So that's an ocarina there. This is a ceramic ocarina. This is about 4,000 rupees. Got this online.
Online?
Yeah. This is more of a collector's item. It's not more to play because it's not perfectly in tune. But it does make a sound. This is actually from, there's a game called Legend of Zelda. So there's a person playing the ocarina in that. That's what I found out about this instrument, actually.
Your knowledge is amazing.
So yeah, that's where I found out about this instrument. And again, this is a prized possession. It's like a collector's edition kind of thing. So it's very shiny and.
And the last is the pot.
The last is the pot. Yes, this one, right?
Yeah.
So this is the Dahi pot. That's why it's painted like this. It was in my hostel room at Goa University. So
waiting to be broken.
Waiting to be broken, actually. So one guy just walks in and he starts doing something amazing with it. He goes... He knew how to play it for some reason.
I see.
And I did. I was like, wait, what are you doing with it? He was like, I'm making some sounds. I tried it and I was like, I can't do anything. Then he showed me, like, this has air inside it. So if you... If you do that, it will make some sounds, and you can use this as like a percussive thing.
Amazing.
So yeah, this pot makes amazing music.
The gumot comes close to it, no? Like it's got a
the
gumot skin
is
on one side.
Basically the same thing, except for the,
skin
on
one
side. Yes. These kind of pots are used, actually, I found this out later. Just the empty pot is used as something called a ghatam. The ghatam is a South Indian instrument used by legendary musicians like Vikku Vinayakram and all of these guys. They have played with some big legends of the world. So they just use an empty pot and they can make so many sounds out of it that you'll be amazed that you can do that with just a pot. And they play it like this. They hold it like this and something like that. And it's just amazing. And something very interesting that I found out was the handpan that I'm talking about, my dream instrument, is based off of a ghatam and a steel pan. You know those African steel pans that Trinidad and Tobago bands used to use them?
Yeah.
So it's based out of a ghatam and that one. It's a combination of both of these.
You never know what ends up where.
So Indian instrument to make an instrument in Switzerland, inspiring thing for them. So it was brilliant. I came to know this, I was mind blown. I was like, wow, they are taking inspiration from
Indian
India.
Base and their technology.
Their technology, and they make something astounding out of it.
Yeah.
Something really crazy, something really beautiful.
You know, Gaurav, actually I showed photographs of musical instruments at one stage for some photo library in the UK and all that. And just discovering the diversity of instruments was amazing, and sometimes you couldn't find information on these things, you know.
Right.
Now, of course, the net has much more information. There used to be people coming down for these craft utsavs and all that, with the musical shows, the kind of instruments. They would tell you a name, what's this, they would tell you a name, but they couldn't explain it because like they are not given to explanations and theorizing and, you know.
Correct. So, that's that. It's all about going out, finding out more about the instrument. And I really feel what you said. I feel that if you find out more about the instrument, where it comes from, you know, what kind of people play it, I think you get more inspired to play music from that instrument.
It has a context. No, we need to understand the context.
The context has to be understood.
Yeah.
You have to, you know, have an idea as to, of course, you can learn it without the context, but if there is a context, it's much better.
We are back at literature class, at which point we'll take a break and go to our next session.
Yes.